Here at the Salem News, we're talking Fantastic Five football, the Mount Rushmores of all of our various high schools, choosing the top five football players as we try to lead into the 2014 season. Here, chatting about a school near and dear to your heart, Matt, the parochial school, reigning Super Bowl champions, Bishop Fenwick, and certainly on this Mount Rushmore is one of the big guys on that Super Bowl championship squad, Nick Bonner. Obviously, Derek Collins, another Super Bowl winner, Bobby Tarr, John Manning, and
Mike Cranny,
the fifth. Matt, certainly a school that you know a lot about, a program that you've followed for a long time, and I think one of the things that really jumps out to me was that, from a lot of our schools, Fenwick has probably the biggest preponderance of modern players. But when you think about it, in the last 20 years or so, they have, three Super Bowl championships and five Super Bowl appearances, which probably stacks up with just about anybody in the area, certainly in their division as far as Super Bowls goes. So it makes sense that they'd have some modern guys on that list.
Yeah, I mean, really, in the Dave Woods era, they've been tremendous. I mean, there was a bit of a wall for, five or six years there before, this Bonner-led group kind of got things going and turned around. But yeah, they've had so much success during that time that naturally they produced some good players. And, if we're working backwards, Nick Bonner is an obvious choice. Finished his career with, I believe, two tackles shy of 500. Mm-hmm. Started 4 years on defense. Became a great offensive player for them as a senior, as the quarterback, throwing for 1,400 yards and, 12 touchdowns or 14 touchdowns, and then running for, another 12 and 800, almost 900 yards. So he did everything for them. I mean, literally did everything for them other than kick extra points as a senior. So he was an amazing all-around player and the type of guy that we wanted to put on a list like this. Derek Collins, very similar in that sense. Different in stature. Nick was obviously a smaller guy and played with a lot of heart. Derek was big, strong, fullback, linebacker, and played the game both ways. Also a tough runner, could catch the ball out of the backfield. And then defensively, he was really the heart and soul of those Super Bowl teams in 98 and 99 for Woods. And Tarr, his numbers speak for themselves, off the charts, third all time, I believe, still in the state for rushing with, 5,600 yards, 70 touchdowns.
And, it's a lot of
touchdowns.
Just,
it's crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, one of the stats that I dug up there was in those 2 years in as a junior and senior, he ran for over 200 yards 16 times,
yeah,
which is insane. And then 4 times over 300 yards, which
and
is
we
just
get
ridiculous.
Guys, we chart the Century Club, we get guys, they start racking up 10, 15, 100 yard games, and that's pretty impressive. That's something that we'll throw out for some stats to lean on, and to turn that into 200 yards is really unheard of. I mean,
right.
and Bobby was not just a juker, I mean, he was a straight edge runner. He was the kind of guy that could carry the ball as many times a game as you wanted him to, and a rugged guy, a durable guy, not prone to the hamstring pulls or the nicks that you see with some of these guys that are based on pure speed running off the edge. So, I mean, Bobby, certainly if they didn't need him so much on offense, could have played on defense too. He was tough enough and built enough to tackle guys.
Right, he was. And one of the things that gets overlooked with Bobby too, I think, is that during those 2 years, Fenwick had a pretty good-sized line and a decent line then, but it was kids were always in and out of the lineup, those linemen. So he was playing with a different line almost every game. It was really fascinating to see. He kind of was, the latest in a pretty good line of really good running backs at Fenwick. And that's one of the things I found when I did the research. And another guy who made the list, John Manning, was probably the first great running back that Fenwick had, and he made the list from, he played in 63 and 64 were his football seasons. Very early in the program only started in 62, but he made an impact right away. As his assistant coach said, Ralph LaDuke, he said that he wasn't necessarily the fastest or the strongest, but he found a way to shake tackles, elude tacklers and defenders, and then once he did, he was gone. And one of the stories that, you know, he told me was that, you know, and one of the assistant coaches used to go up to the officials before the games and say, you know what, when he gets the ball, don't blow the whistle too early, because sometimes you think he's down, mm-hmm. and then he'd break
and
it,
not.
And he's gone.
Yeah.
And also another story that came from that was, you know, one of the drills they used to run was, you know, something where it was one ball carrier against two defenders. And when they sent John back there with the ball, they would say, you know what, we're not going to tackle there because we can't tackle him, but we're going to put four guys out there and you just have to try to tag him. Mm-hmm. And it would still be, you know, difficult for them to do. So,
so
he was
agile.
Right. And yeah, so he was just elusive and, you know, one of probably the first good back in Fenwick history. And, you know, the fifth guy on that list, Mike Cranny, was someone who was kind of rare for his time. I think it was the late 80s he played, and he was a pass-catching machine. You know,
wow.
Had
yeah.
a season of 51 catches, which was a record.
That's
until,
amazing. Holy moly.
Until Ryan Lipka broke it with his, you know, crazy season. And, you
that's
know,
a lot of catches.
Recently.
Yeah.
And he went on to a career at UNH, so he was a deserving candidate, too. So.
Absolutely. Well, let's just touch on Nick again real quick. I mean, we obviously watched him very recently. He's one of the most recent guys on any of these lists, and you know, the games that come to mind for me, you know, Pingree, a game that he just wasn't going to let his team lose. He wanted the undefeated season, and then that Super Bowl, you know, the very, you and I have talked about this before, but that very first play, you know, the opponent runs a trick play, you know, they did not fool Nick at all, and he came from way out, if you watch it on tape, he comes from way out of the frame, blows up the trick play, and really just kind of seems to set the tone for the rest of that game. Bishop Fenwick, 28-zip, whitewashing, and I think, you know, in general, that play kind of sums up Nick Bonner, you know, heady, hard-hitting, and just great instincts for the game, and really those instincts were really important to what makes him a great football player, and, you know, the lesson of authority that Coach Woods says that he's the best one that he's coached.
Yeah, I mean, that first play, like you said, that's who he was. I mean, that was, doing the research, I went back and found a story right before the Super Bowl, and one of the last things Nick said was, you know, I don't want to go out with a loss in the Super Bowl. There'll be nothing worse. And I think that kind of attitude just carried over. And right away, as soon as that ball's in play, he's all about winning. And that's what, you know, that's what made him who he was. And I think he helped. He didn't carry that team because they were a talented bunch for sure.
Yeah.
But they certainly fed off of his energy and his you know, determination and his work ethic and all those things. And he helped them become the Super Bowl champion that they were.
Absolutely a complete football player, too. I think, you know, not a kid that was, like, a little bit too fast for his division or was doing it on athleticism. He was really doing it on football acumen and instincts and could really play any position. You know, really just what we were looking for when we were looking for this series, you know, because we've done quarterbacks in the past. We've done skills positions in the past, and in football players, we were looking for the rugged types, the types with the instincts, the tackling, and those types of things. And I think Nick really, even though he is technically a quarterback, really fits that bill.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you don't see too many 5'8", 150-pound linebackers, but he had played 3 years as a safety, and I think he really, Dave Woods had no other choice but to put him up at linebacker because that's the way he played as a safety anyways.
Exactly.
Even though he was size, it wasn't about the size with him. It was about, you know, his heart and that football player mentality that he had.
Loyal Malloy of Division 5, if you will. Mm-hmm. So that's Bishop Fenwick. Stick with us for the rest of the Fantastic Five series as we lead into the 2014 high school football season. Matt Williams and Matt Jenkins here at the Salem News.